We'll go on now to talk a bit about the final step of RNA metabolism, right, which is translation, where mRNA is now turned into a different language, sort of. Transcription was reading off DNA and converting one deoxynucleotide sequence into a ribonucleotide sequence. But now we're actually translating it into a different language, right? We're going from one macromolecule, a nucleotide, to another amino acid. So within the mRNA, right, we have these codons. And the codons are just triplets of mRNA nucleotides that will give some specific amino acid in a protein. And they have to be read with the correct reading frame. So it depends where you start and where you stop. And we'll find out there are 64 codons because there are simply four, right, nucleotides, A, U, C, and T. And if you raise those to an exponential dependence of the different numbers of basically the different combinations of those, then you can get 64 possibilities, but there's some redundancy in the amino acids that they code for. So the anticodons, these are also triplets, but they're on tRNA molecules. They're triplets within a tRNA polymer. And there's going to be a specific anticodon for each amino acid. Okay, so the macromolecule that really does the majority of the work in translation is tRNA. And tRNA, along with the help of ribosomal subunits, is going to take this mRNA strand where I've shown one codon, UUU. This codes for the amino acid phenylalanine. So at the 3' end of this tRNA, we'll see that the phenylalanine amino acid makes a covalent bond there, or it is carried, right, to the ribosome by the tRNA. And then from 5 to 3, right, notice that these are drawn anti-parallel. You can read the anticodon sequence. Okay, in this case, it would be AAA. And you get these hydrogen bonds. Of course, here there would be 6 between the tRNA and the mRNA that's being translated. And those hydrogen bonds, right, bring the two RNA types together. And through a catalytic mechanism, this phenylalanine is then added on to the growing peptide. And of course, one single tRNA is going to be specific for one amino acid. So a minimum of 20 tRNAs are required since there are 20 naturally occurring amino acids. I think there's actually more than that for some genetic diversity. But theoretically, a cell could get by with a minimum of 20. So I mentioned the organelle that assists in this process is the ribosome. And it facilitates protein synthesis in the N to C direction. We've talked in this class about primary sequence of proteins or the primary structure. And remember, there's a directionality where the first amino acid in line has a free ammonium ion, that's the N terminal. And then the last one has a free carboxylate, the C terminal. So there's a directionality to protein synthesis, just like there is to DNA and RNA synthesis. And the reaction that's occurring, right, is an amide bond formation. or a peptide bond formation. So in other words, if you have some amino acid at the N-terminal, let's say this is the first one in line, the next amino acid that will be added on also has a free ammonium ion before reaction. And we'll call that R2. And then the peptide bond forms. And you get this structure. Where R2 and R1 are trans about the peptide bond. So what type of reaction is that? General type. Think about what atoms we lose.
Condensation reaction?
Condensation, right? Because we make a new bond between C and N. And not only do we do that, but we lose water. So there's two H's from the, I'll show those explicitly here. I'll draw NH2 and then the extra H that stays. You lose that H2 and the oxygen. And the directionality is because we specifically use the nitrogen as the nucleophile for amino acid 2 and the carboxylate as the electrophile. So this is catalyzed by a series of enzymes, but the main players are tRNA and then the ribosomal organelles. So if you think about some different codons, the one that tells translation to start, or this is the beginning of the peptide, this is AUG, and this codes for methionine. So of course the anticodon for this could be read backwards. The A is at the 5' end, the G is at the 3' end of the mRNA. So the anticodon on the tRNA that will base pair with AUG, we also write it from 5 to 3, but it would be C, right, AU, where C forms hydrogen bonds with G, and then A and U also base pair. And 3 codons are actually used to initiate or tell the ribosome to dissociate. These are UAA, UAG, and UGA. They stop translation. So we get ribosomal mRNA dissociation. And the free peptide is dissociating as well. Now, just keep in mind one more concept about these codons, right? We said there are 64 codons that are unique, but there's only 20 amino acids. So there's going to be some redundancy. In other words, you can have the same amino acid coded for by multiple codons, and this is known as the wobble position. So if you look up in your codon chart, phenylalanine is coded for by UUU and UUC. Okay, so these 3 pyrimidine sequences. And what's fundamental for phenylalanine is these first 2 U's here, right? That's what they hold in common. But the wobble position could be U or C. And this gives some flexibility as to what anticodon could be in the tRNA. So you want to be able to define those terms and understand sort of the basic steps of translation. There's a